One of the weirdest parts about discussing world religions is that there's actually no agreement about just what a religion is in the first place. Now, there are some easy ones, like Judaism, although even that's complicated, or Islam, or of course Christianity. But other belief systems aren't so easy. For instance, what about atheism? If God exists, is a religious claim? Is God doesn't exist? Or how about agnosticism with a claim like, I don't know if God exists? Or what about the Eastern systems of belief that are often kind of vague about the existence or the non-existence of God? There's an old Chinese adage, three teachings harmonious as one, which is used to describe the coexistence of Buddhism, Taoism, and Confucianism. The idea is that you don't need to choose one. The three teachings could coexist within a society and even within an individual. But are those three teachings, three religions, or philosophies, or lifestyles, or all of the above? These questions are a little harder to answer than it might seem at first. So let me give you a few of the ways that people have tried to answer the question, what is a religion? St. Thomas Aquinas points to the pagan rhetorician Cicero, who defines religion as consisting in offering service and ceremonial rites to a superior nature that men call divine. Understood this way, a person who is spiritual but not religious would be someone who believes that there is a superior divine nature of some kind, but who doesn't bother to offer that divinity service or ceremonial rites. The difficulty with this definition of religion is that some of the things that ordinarily get classified as religions, like Theravada Buddhism, don't clearly fit. Our own Jimmy Akin gives a somewhat similar definition. He says, religion is a system of belief about the divine and or the afterlife. The major difference here is that he's focusing on belief, whereas Cicero had focused on practice. Well, the French sociologist Emile Durkheim is going to give a definition that sort of splits the difference. He says that a religion is a unified system of beliefs and practices relative to sacred things. That is to say, things set apart and surrounded by prohibitions, beliefs and practices that unite its adherents in a single moral community called a church. Okay, now Durkheim argues that religion should be understood as something distinct from the question, do I believe in God or not? Or even, what sort of God do I believe in? Or at least he's going to argue that those dogmatic questions are just a part of what it is to be a religion. He argues instead that religion is a whole, formed of parts, a more or less complex system of myths, dogmas, rites, and ceremonies. Now, Durkheim's definition, his view of what a religion is a lot broader than Aquinas's, and we might even critique it perhaps as being a bit too broad. Certainly, some people have argued that some political and economic systems could even fall into Durkheim's definition of religion. Nevertheless, taken together, between the definition given by Cicero, by Jimmy Akin, and by Durkheim, we're left with something of a sense, maybe a little bit of a working definition. Religion is a system of belief and practices about what is sacred. For some religions, particularly Western ones, that's going to specifically mean how we live our lives in response to God. In other cases, especially the Eastern religions, there's more of a sense in living in what we might call proper spiritual harmony, in a way that doesn't always explicitly refer to a personal God of any kind. So that's going to be one way of getting to the question. There's another way of getting at the same idea, however. Nostra Aetate, the Second Vatican Council's statement on non-Christian religions, looks at the questions that religion tries to answer. It says, quote, men expect from the various religions answers to the unsolved riddles of the human condition, which today, even as in former times, deeply stir the hearts of men. What is man? What is the meaning, the aim of our life? What is moral good? What is sin? Whence suffering, and what purpose does it serve? Which is the road to true happiness? What are death, judgment, and retribution after death? What finally is that ultimate inexpressible mystery which encompasses our existence? Whence do we come? And where are we going? End quote. Notice here, this isn't so much asking, what do they believe? Or what do they do? But something in some ways even more fundamental. What questions are religions trying to answer? Rabbi Abraham Heschel says much the same thing in his own definition when he says that religion is an answer to man's ultimate questions. If you understand that that way, anyone answering the question, what happens to me when I die, or why is there evil in the world, is answering a religious question. By that definition, atheism and even agnosticism are religions in that they're answering religious questions. They're answering the question of God. Even the person who says the questions don't matter is making a claim about religion. They're making a religious claim. So there you have it. Hopefully, you have both on the one hand a general sense of what everyone means by religion, and on the other hand, a sense for why it's hard to draw the lines any more precisely, or why it's been all but impossible to come to any kind of universal agreement as to which systems of thought are in and which ones are out of the category of religion. In this series, I'm going to largely split the difference amongst the definitions that I've shared. We've got to draw the line somewhere. And I admit that is inescapably going to be a little bit arbitrary. For instance, I'll refer to Confucianism, but I'm treating Confucianism as out, because Confucius himself seems to have tried to avoid religious questions. In the Analects, Chi Lu actually asks him about men's duty to spirits, and Confucius replies, "Before we're able to do our duty by the living, how can we do it by the spirits of the dead?" You know, he likewise avoids answering the whole afterlife question by simply saying, "Before we know what life is, how can we know what death is?" So for similar reasons, agnosticism also I'm going to treat as out. Inasmuch as at least some forms of agnosticism are really refusals or attempts to refuse to either ask or answer the religious questions. On the other hand, we will look a little bit at atheism because it is answering the religious questions, even if the answers that it provides to them are in the negative. That's still going to leave a related question, though, which we're going to get into in the next lesson. Why are we calling these other world religions religions? Why do Christians not generally refer to them as other faiths? It turns out there's a very good reason for that. But as I've said, that is a question for next time.
If you enjoyed learning how to explain and defend our Catholic faith, make sure you check out School of Apologetics. In our self-paced courses, Jimmy Akin teaches the fundamentals of apologetic dialogue. Trent Horn shows how to defend life beginning at conception. On top of that, other trusted experts give courses on church history, creation, purgatory, the saints, and more. Sign up today because a faith you can defend is a faith you can own and embrace. SchoolofApologetics.com.